Keynote is best known as Apple's equivalent to PowerPoint, but as you'll see, it is secretly a powerful graphic design tool that can even do some things better than Photoshop. I'm not saying it replaces Photoshop, especially when it comes to creating from scratch or doing subtle touch-ups, but when it comes to quickly working with multiple layers, aligning elements, and finalizing designs, you might find Keynote easier to use. I consider it my secret weapon for graphic design. But enough hype, let's get into Keynote. When it first opens up, you can just choose a basic white template, just double click to open it, and then we're just going to click and delete out each of these text elements since we want to start from scratch. Now you'll notice that on the right side of Keynote, we have this area with some information in it, and this is the inspector panel. We're going to be using this area a lot as we design here in Keynote, and depending on what element we have selected in our project, we're going to have different options over there in the inspector panel. But for now, let's get our page size set up. So over here in the inspector panel, I'm going to click on document. This is where we have all of our high level document properties. So you'll notice that down here we have a section that says slide size. And I will say that this is a little awkward setting this up in Keynote. Remember, it's not designed for graphic design. It's made for presentations, but it will work, trust me. So when we look inside of slide size, notice that we have two options, and if you're creating a design that is either a 4:3 aspect ratio or 16:9, you can just use one of these options. However, if you want to do a custom slide size, you can by clicking on custom slide size, and notice that you can enter a custom size. Do note that it's not in pixels, it's in Apple points, which is very similar. It will work pretty much exactly the same, but do note that there is a little bit of a difference, and that is why it's kind of awkward. So just enter the dimensions that you'd like. I'm going to be creating a YouTube thumbnail, so I'm just going to choose the 16:9 aspect ratio. To start adding elements to our document, we can actually just drag them right in here. So I have this folder on my desktop, and I have some elements. So I'm just going to click, and I'm going to drag this image in here into Keynote. And you'll notice that it comes right in, and now I can kind of move it around. Alternatively, I could have gone up here into the Insert menu. And this is where you can add a whole bunch of things here in Keynote. So if I wanted to add an image like I just did, I would go down to choose, and then I could choose the location on my computer for the image. But notice that in this area, not all of these options are used for graphic design, but text box, shape, and line are definitely used a lot. So we could add a text box, and you'll notice this in the middle is kind of small right now, but we're going to change that here in a little bit. We could also add a shape, and you'll notice that you have some different shape options. We're actually going to use a shape, so let's go ahead and add a rectangle. Notice that it comes in, it's a black rectangle, but we can change the shape, size, color, and all of that sort of thing. And do notice that you can also add lines either with or without arrowheads. We don't need it for this project, so I'm not going to add that right now, but do note that that is an option. Okay, so we've brought in this big image here that I'm going to use as the background for my thumbnail. Now, to make it a little bit easier to work here in Keynote, we're going to zoom out a little bit. And you can zoom either using this dropdown up here at the top left, or you can do Command Shift and then either the comma key to zoom out or the period key to zoom in. And you're going to be zooming in and out a lot, just like you would in any graphic design program, so get used to doing that. So we've zoomed out a little bit. Now I can just drag this image. You'll notice that it scales very nicely. It's going to get as big as the original image's dimensions will allow. So we can go ahead and we can kind of put this in position. Now you'll notice that because we were moving this image around, we're not seeing our text and our shape that well. We can always drag these outside of the actual document and they're still available to us, but now we can just see them better over here as well. In addition to moving and scaling this image, if I click on it, I can then look over here into the inspector window and I can go to the format section. And now I can format all sorts of things about this image. Notice that we have three tabs up here, style, image, and arrange. We're going to use all three of those tabs a lot as we do graphic design here in Keynote. So in the style area, we can choose some of these pre-formatted styles, which kind of add a certain border. I tend not to use those too much, so just kind of go with the default. And then we could add a border to our image if we wanted to. We can add shadows, which we'll look at when we add some text. We could create a reflection, and you can also change the opacity. So, you know, for background images, sometimes this is nice. Sometimes you don't want it to be 100%. Let's go ahead and let's look at the image tab. In here, one feature I really like about Keynote is this replace feature. So what I tend to do is I tend to create templates for my YouTube thumbnails. I create templates here in Keynote that I reuse over and over, and obviously I'm changing a lot of elements. But if I wanted to, say, change this background image. Instead of just dragging in a new image and resizing it, I can just hit replace and choose a new image on my computer, and it will bring in that new image in the same size as the old image, filling up the same area. So that's a really useful feature to quickly change things up in your projects. We can also edit the mask of this image. So when I click on that, it's essentially cropping it, but we're not losing the original image. So you'll see what I mean here. I don't really like seeing all this overflow. In my final project, we're not going to see this, right? If I were to export this, but I don't like seeing it when I'm designing either, because it kind of confuses me to what the final project is going to look like. So if I bring all of these edges in here and then I click done, we've now edited the mask on this image, so we don't see where it's bleeding over. But if I go in and I edit the mask again, instead of, you know, dragging this out and then moving it around, I can just move the image within that mask. So you'll notice it's only going to be shown within my document, but I can kind of pick the parts of the image that I want to show. So that's just a really useful feature here in Keynote. I hit done and you'll notice that it's masked all back up again. We can also adjust the exposure of our image, the saturation. They have an auto enhance here in Keynote that you can use, and then they have some advanced sliders. This is the adjust image. So this is the type of stuff that you get in image editing programs that are made specifically for images. So this is one of the reasons why I like it as a graphic design tool. The Arrange tab deals with moving elements around in our document and also where they lie in terms of the object list, or if you use Photoshop, in terms of what layer they're on. So before I go any further, I do want to display the object list. So I'm going to go up here to the View menu, and up here in the View menu, I'm going to click on Show Object List. So that brings up a list of objects, and these are in order. The one on top is in the front, and then the one on the bottom is in the back. So for instance, let's go ahead and let's click on this square, and I'm going to go over to the style section for the square, and you'll notice that we have some different options here than we had for the image. So we can give it color fills. So I can give it a regular color fill or a gradient. There's a lot of options here. And I can click on the color wheel to choose my color, and again, tons of options for colors. I actually have my color palette right here in Keynote, so I can just use these different colors, but I just want to make this square a different color, this rectangle, so that we can see it better. So I just chose this color. Then I can close that out. Notice that we can also create borders, shadows, reflections, and change the opacity for the shape. But when I bring this shape on top of my design, you'll notice that right now it's on top. But if I go up here to the object list and I move the square, just clicking and dragging to the bottom, now it's behind the background image, right? So layers work just like they do in Photoshop, which is another reason why Keynote is so powerful. Okay, so we need one more element to really make this thumbnail. It's another image I have. It's in my project files. So let me open that up. And I actually have two versions of it because I want to show you something. So I'm going to bring in this first one here, and we're going to take a look at this real quick. So I brought in this image. Obviously, it was shot in front of a green screen, and I'm going to want to remove that green screen background. Now, I tend to remove the backgrounds on iPhone because it works really well. I also sometimes use GIMP, but you can do it here in Keynote. So I have this image selected. I'm going to go up. I'm in Format. We're almost always using Format here in Keynote. We're not using Animate and Document, only Document at the beginning, because we're not making a presentation. We're doing graphic design. So I'm going to click on the Image tab, and you'll notice that there's an option to remove the background. And it kind of gives me an option to drag all of the colors that I want to remove. So obviously, I don't want to remove my skin color, right? So you kind of find the sweet spot there and hit Done, and you'll notice that it removes the background. Now, here's the thing. Look under my armpit here. You'll notice there's some green right there. So it's not perfect, but it does work pretty good if you have a big contrast between your subject and the background. Now, that's the reason why I have a second image, because I have the second one where I just removed the background on my iPhone, and I think that one comes out a little better. So let's bring that one in. Again, just dragging and dropping. And you'll notice that under my armpit there, there's no green. You can remove backgrounds here in Keynote. That's why I wanted to show you. Depends on, you know, how perfect you want it to be, but overall, it does work pretty well. So we'll just move this graphic around. We'll maybe scale it up a little bit. Okay, so we now have our two image elements, and like I said, you know, if we move this to the bottom of the object list, it goes behind, so we've got our layers, right? So now what I want to do is I'm going to create some text here at the bottom, but I want kind of a background for the text, so that's what this square is for, and you'll notice that right now it's behind me. So let's go ahead and let's bring that forward in our object list. And we'll bring this to the bottom and we'll kind of just rough it out. We're going to adjust the size of this square here in a few minutes. But let's just kind of get it down there. And now we'll go ahead and we'll take our text element, which is sitting way outside, and we'll look at modifying text a little bit. So I'm going to put that over the square. Oops, we have to move it in our object list, change its layer. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go over here to the text tab before I even type in it, just to make it a little bit easier to see. You'll notice that we have all of our text formatting options. So I can go ahead and I can change the font. We'll just make this say like Arial Black maybe, or maybe just regular Arial. And we'll make it bold. I'm going to change the size. Let's start at like 200. And I'm just going to click in here and type forever. This is a thumbnail that I've already made, but I'm remaking it here in this video as an example. I have a couple other examples to show you towards the end as well. Let's go ahead and make this bigger. Can we go to 260? Obviously, you know, their aesthetic appeal comes into play here. I'm not going to go into all of that. You guys are probably even better at that than I am. What I do want to show you is how Keynote aligns things. This is the reason why I started using Keynote for graphic design to begin with. Look at how awesome this is. So I have this text element, and as I drag it, look at these yellow lines. It's snapping as I move around this page. So let me just move this box out for a second. If I want to find the very center of this page, look at that. That's the center. I'm snapped in the very middle, right? I can also go up here, and now it's going to start trying to align it with other elements on the page. I think this is a 1/3. Where was I here? 1/3 alignment, so it's 1/3 of the way through the page. And this happens, you know, when you move elements around, they'll snap with each other so that they're aligned. You can snap, you notice the two left edges of these elements. This is one of the absolute best features of Keynote. So I get this rectangle and it's right in the middle, I know because of the snapping. And then I'm going to bring forever down here. And I'm going to get this in the middle as well, right there. Notice I have my two guidelines. Now I'm going to drop it. And I want to change some of the colors here. So I have the rectangle selected. If you're having trouble selecting elements because one element is behind another element, you can always select them in the object list, remember. So we'll go ahead and we're going to change our text color. And I do need to have the text selected, at least the text box element selected. So we'll make that white, and then we're going to change this rectangle. I just selected it. We're going to go to the style section. We're going to look at fill. And we're going to make this kind of a yellow. I think I have one in my palette. So there you have it. Now, we're almost done. Obviously, you know, you can do a lot more. But one thing I do want to show you is I just want to show adding a little bit of shadows. So we'll add a little drop shadow to forever. We can kind of change, you know, the blur on it if we want. We can change the offset. And we'll go ahead and we will also add a little bit of a shadow to this square as well, this rectangle. And you can kind of play around just so that it kind of pops out a little bit. Obviously, that is up to you. And so now we've kind of finished this thumbnail. Now, I can obviously go in and I can edit the mask on this image so that I see what the actual thumbnail looks like. If you are creating a YouTube thumbnail, one thing I like to do to kind of have an idea of what my thumbnail is going to look like is look at it up here in the top left because it's smaller and you can see what it would look like, you know, as, say, a thumbnail. Okay, now let me show you something else that I find really cool about Keynote before we go ahead and export this thumbnail, is if you're working on a project and you're kind of brainstorming and you don't know exactly what design you want to use, being able to copy and paste so easily in Keynote really makes things much more efficient. So we are working in a presentation software, so we can copy and paste these elements really easily. So I can just click over here in my slide list, and if you're not seeing this, you want to go to the View menu, and you want to make sure that Navigator is selected. And then I can just click on this entire slide and do Command C or go up to Edit and Copy, then Command V, and now I have two versions. So in the second version, I could, you know, start changing the font of this text and doing all sorts of, you know, unique things, and then I can just look over here and I can compare the difference. Now at the same time, this also works with elements. So I could go into this first slide and I could take this element right here, Command C to copy it, go over to my second slide, Command V to paste it. Now I've got two of me in there. And so you can mix and match between these slides really, really easily. It's great for doing multiple variations of a particular design, and then you can see all of the variations really easy, really quickly. When you open up the project, they all open up at once. I mean, this is a powerful tool. Okay, let's talk about exporting. So delete this extra element. Let's say this is all done, and I want to export it. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go up to File, and I'm going to go to Export To. You'll notice that we have a number of different options in here. The one that I'm usually using is Images. And we can choose which type of image we would like to export it to. Now you do have to pay attention to how many images you're exporting. So if I only want to export this second one, I'm going to choose from slide 2 to slide 2. Generally, I export them as the highest quality available here in Keynote JPEG, and we can just save it. We'll just call it test, and we'll hit export. Now I export it to this project files folder, so if we look in there, we now have this folder called test, and inside of it, we have our thumbnail. Just real quick, I want to show you a couple more things in the view menu. There might be some things you're interested in. I want to show you that you can show the rulers in here, so you can have rulers inside of your document. And then you also have, if you select, say, you know, a particular image, you can go to view, and then you can click on the show adjust image. You can also get here from the inspector, but sometimes it's easiest just to use the drop menu, and then you can adjust that image accordingly. I've opened up another project here quickly to demonstrate another use case and show you how you can harness the power of Keynote with design. So this is actually how I made the graphic that you've seen behind me here on the wall. So what I did is I took the Keynote logo, and what I wanted is I wanted the entire background of the slide to be the Keynote gradient. But if I scale this up, it becomes pixelated, and then of course we have the image in the middle, so we can't, you know, just have the blue background. I could take just a piece of it, but when I scale that out or try and duplicate it, it's not going to look good. So what did I do? Well, first of all, what I did is I inserted a shape, and I inserted a rectangle, and then I made the rectangle the entire size of my document, right there. And then what I did is I brought the Keynote image to the front, so I have access to it, and we'll shrink it down a little bit. Just put it off to the side here. Now to choose the gradient for this rectangle, I selected the rectangle. I'm going to go over to Style. I'm going to choose Color Fill, Gradient Fill. You'll notice that we now have two color options where we can start and end our gradient. So I can click on the color wheel for the first one, and I'm just going to now select the eyedropper over here in our color selector. I'm going to go to the Keynote logo that I have and select the lightest color blue. Then I'll click on the other color wheel, go back to the eyedropper, and select the darkest color blue. And you'll notice that I have now created the Keynote gradient for the logo, but it's, you know, full size, it's not pixelated, anything like that. So then what I did is I went into this logo right here, and I went to the Format and then Image tab, and I did, you guessed it, I removed the background. So we want to click and drag over the colors to remove. So you'll notice we don't want to remove, you know, where it's going into the actual image in the middle there. So I think we're pretty safe right about there. Hit done, and you'll notice that we've now removed that extra square background in our original image, and we have the Keynote gradient behind it. And we did it removing the background, using the eyedropper to select our colors, all here in Keynote, an application that wasn't originally developed for graphic design, but works amazingly for it. And of course, there are a whole bunch of other options that I haven't shown you, but I have shown you all of the main primary graphic design features that I use in Keynote on a regular basis. I do want to mention, some of you might not know this, but Keynote is also available for Windows. I haven't used it on Windows. I do use Windows, but when I'm using Keynote, I use it on Mac. But if you've used Keynote for Windows, I would love to hear in the comments section below how it's working out for you. So there you have it. I hope you now understand how Keynote can be used as a powerful graphic design tool. If you found the video helpful, I would really appreciate a thumbs up here on YouTube. And if you want to see more content like this, whether it's Keynote, Mac, or just other cool things that you can do with technology, don't forget to subscribe to the channel. That's all I have for you for today. This is Anson from AnsonAlex.com.